is Celtic will take on Juventus, the Italian champions. Real Madrid will come up against Manchester United, and Arsenal will come up against the beaten finalists of last season, Bayern Munich, the first leg to be played in February. Let's go live to Neon, where the draw took place, get some more Celtic reaction now with our chief football reporter, Nick Collins. Nick.
Yes, and I've got the Celtic chief executive, Peter Lawwell, here with me. Peter, your reaction first and foremost to getting Juventus?
A fantastic draw, really formidable draw, one of Europe's greatest clubs. But we'll be ready. You know, we've done magnificently well kneeling the lads and the qualifiers and through to the group stage. But we'll be ready, and I'm sure we'll give a great account of ourselves.
And it might have been a decade or so ago, but you know as a club you can beat Juventus, well,
yeah,
because you
absolutely.
Did it.
Yeah, our record with Juventus has been very good. I think over the years they've won one, two, we've won two. It was an inspirational night at Celtic Park in 2001 when we beat them 4-3. A typical Celtic night. The supporters were magnificent. It was a great atmosphere and a great spectacle for the game. So hopefully we can replicate that when they come to Celtic Park.
Do you think it'll be a case of reproducing the spirit of that famous night against Barcelona if you are to progress further into the competition?
Yeah, we've shown we can do it. We've had some great results. Juventus, as I say, are top of the Serie A at the moment. They're a fantastic side. But it'll probably take that level of performance. And who's to say we can't do that?
Just what has it been like for Celtic back in the Champions League? But not only that, competing really well in a very tough group and now through to this stage.
Yeah, well, we believe we're one of the top European clubs in everything we do, and Celtic should be at this level, not just for the revenue, but in terms of the profile and exposure and for the club. And that's where we really should be. And to get back in it after 2 or 3 years has been magnificent. We went into the unknown slightly because it's a new young management team we have who are extremely talented and ambitious. It's a new young team that we have. So we're going to the unknown a wee bit, but they've been fantastic, absolutely fantastic. And we go into this game with a degree of confidence.
And with the success that you're having in the Champions League, can that change things in terms of the January transfer window and the funds that may be available because you're being successful in Europe?
Well, every transfer window we get into, we aim to be out stronger at the other end. And January is, as you know, is not the best time to be doing it. But our intention will be to come out the window stronger. And if that means finding some value in the transfer market, then that's what we'll do. And we're delighted here, you know, to be flying the flag for Scottish football. It's taken a bit of a battering recently. And flying the flag for Celtic supporters and Scottish football.
Your story in the Champions League so far has been one of the great stories of this season's competition. I mean, it's a wonderful adventure. How far can it go?
Yeah, well, who knows? You know, we've beaten the best, both home and away. And we, as I say, it's a formidable task. But we get into the game with great confidence in our management team and our players. And let's see what happens.
Well, Peter, best of luck and many thanks for joining us. That's Peter Lawwell, the chief executive of Celtic. And, of course, they'll be facing the Italian champions, Juventus.